Jainer and children, very good morning. Today we will do chapter 9, how many times? Now today again we will do the concept of multiplication. What is multiplication? Multiplication is repeated addition. So instead of adding equal amounts repeatedly to find the sum, we can multiply to find the same result in a much quicker way. Now the properties of multiplication. There are four properties of multiplication. Understanding these properties are rules that will make solving multiplication problems easier. First is commutative property. You can switch the order of the factors and it won't change the answer. Like we multiply 3 with 6 is equal to 18, or 6 multiplied by 3 is equal to 18. The product is same. Second, associative property. You can change the placement of the parentheses, but it won't change the answer. In the bracket, when we put 2 number 3 multiplied by 2 and then multiply by 4, that is equal to 24. But again, if we change the number, like 3 multiplied by 2, we do that 6 multiplied by 4 is equal to 24. Or again, we change the placement, the 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 4, or we put the two numbers in the bracket then again, but the answer, the product is same. So you can change the placement of the parentheses, but it won't change the answer. Then distributive property. A multiplication factor can be broken into distributed, a sum of two other multiplication factors. Like 24 multiplied by 3 is equal to what product? So what we will do, we have written 24 in an expanded form, that is 20 plus 4, then multiply by 3. So now we will separately multiply 3 with 20 and 4 with 3, and then whatever the answer we get, it is 80 plus 12 we have got is equal to 92. In this way also we can show the multiplication, and this is called distributive property. Identify property. The product of any number and 1 is always that number. Like 4 multiplied by 1 is equal to 4, or 32 multiplied by 1 is equal to 32. The product of any number and 0 is 0. Means when we multiply any number with 0, that is 0 only. So like 4 multiplied by 0 is equal to 0, 32 multiplied by 0 is equal to 0. Skip count. Counting objects in equal groups of 2 or more. You can see the examples, children. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12. Here we have counted by 2's, and another one, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18. This is counting by 3's. Here you can see that it is the table form also. Like you say, tell the tables that 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8 and so on. Same way it is here. Okay, and then another one, counting by 5's, 5. 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. And you can see other examples also. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Here again, the gap is of 10. Now 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. Here we have counted by hundreds. Now, what is skip counting again? In math, skip counting can be defined as the method of counting forward by numbers other than 1. To skip count, we keep adding the same number each time to the previous number. Here, we are skip counting by 2s on a number line. See children, you can watch from 0 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6. Every time we are jumping by 2s. So that is also showing the repeated additions also you can see. See, it is more clear here. You can see 0 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 8, 8 to 10, 10 to 12, 12 to 14. Now let us sing this song before doing some more skip counting examples. Skip counting can be so much fun. Jump the same number from the previous one. A pattern you will see when you are done. Now you will find some patterns which I will be showing you in the further slides, and you will find it that it is very interesting. You must have seen these patterns in Ludo's also when you play Ludo games. So children, let's do it. See, a type of pattern is there when we have done by using the even number, that is counting by twos. When we have used the odd numbers, that is counting by again, see 1 to 3, 3 to 5, we have counted by 2s. But here we have used the odd numbers, which cannot be divided by 2. Then using every fifth number, that is counting by 5s, I have shown you here. Then counting by 10s. Let us learn about skip counting. Skip counting is a counting by a number when it is not 1. Skip counting by tens. It is easy when there is no more counting there except there is an actual number 0. Let us do with this 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100 and so on. Now skip counting by twos, we can learn this. That means you can count the things very faster here. Let us do this, play this game. Let us see who is the winner. Watch it here fully. Now who is the winner? That is counting by twos is the winner and counting by one is not. Now let us count this chocolates faster. 2, 4, 8, 10, 16, 18, 19, so on. So see, this is a great skill to count it very faster by skip counting. Now skip counting by 5s. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60 and so on. You can watch the screen. Now skip counting by 3s, children. Let's do it. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30 and so on. See, it has formed a beautiful pattern too. Now skip counting by 4s. 4, 8, then 12, then 16, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36, 40. It is like the table counting by fours. Now, children, I think you have understood. I have given you so many examples and you have understood the skip counting. It is just like the tables, counting of the tables. Children, no act of kindness, no matter how small it is never wasted. So children, please help everybody. Take care of the plants. Thank you.